this is not quite, oh, I'm struggling to get past, this is not quite finished yet, as you can see. Radio goes there, fish finder was there, plenty of space on the top for other things, compass, storage space behind that front compartment, and storage space under this seat, which has also got seat cushions, and storage behind this cockpit unit. Controls, let's go through there. Oh, it's got anti-slip, non-slip matting stuff on here, tape. And back. Transducer. Bilge pump outlet, splash well, drains, and the Mercury 60. It's got a few marks on top, but the bottom leg is well, virtually, apart from a little piece missing off at skeg at bottom, which is nothing. Propeller looks virtually brand new. In fact, I would say it is brand new because it's got no paint chips on it or wear marks on it. Brand new. Lift motor, that was 150 quid just for the motor. The hydraulic lift, it's got the spare. How this works, I've no idea. The spare engine bracket. I've chip painted a bit there, but I'll touch it up. That was done by putting steering bracket on. Same on that side. A couple of fishing rod holders. Quite a large back fishing area, to be honest with you. You get probably get four in there comfy. What else? Just got the trailer to finish. It was a double axle trailer, however it was not the trailer for this boat, and it's far too big and too heavy, so I've took one of the axles off, moved the other one forward. As you can see, just got the bearings to redo. They're not too bad actually. I'm just going to re-grease them on this. I've put new rollers, or some, not all of them, because there's that many underneath, you can't probably see them. I've put new rollers underneath. I think I've put three new ones on, and there's a spare as well. I think there's about 8 or 9 in total. Put this in process of putting this cross member on here to support the front, because the nearest support for the boat is there, and it's probably 4 foot to here, so I've put in an extra one in. New hatch, brand new hatch, got storage in there, all new Perspex windows. These are not rivets, where are they? They're Allen key nut and bolt stainless, so you can remove them if you had to do for any reason. LED spotlights, twin horns. I'm hoping to get this windscreen completed at front, just a splash guard. I'm going to put some Perspex in there. Comes with an antenna on the trailer, new winch. You see, it's pretty good, and actually everything has been redone on this. The complete floor has been taken out. You can see where I've joined the joint. This focus is terrible on this Sony camera. Sometime today, my god, it's useless. Comes with a big tank, just wants a wash. It's just a bit mucky, that's all, I'm gonna clean out. Everything's brand new centre cockpit. Like I was saying, the floor is completely brand new. It's all the wood. I put, I think it was oak, the centre. Centre rib all the way up underneath. There's videos on YouTube, you can see me actually doing it. Storage in back for your battery, your tank, your bilge pumps in back there. I'm trying to think anything else, because I know people like to know. Mostly original parts which have been cleaned. All this bit in here has been re-wooded. It were all rotten inside there. All your electrics, your cables, and I'm an electrician by the way, so it's all done right. Just bear with me a second, I'll get in. And here is the wiring. That's back of the switches. All the wiring goes up to there. Looks like a bird's nest, but it has got a little mini fuse box. They're not labelled up because there's no room to label them, but things are fused here. You've got a master overload that pops up if it's, this is a short circuit on system. The connection for the radio is here. It's also got, you've got your BNC connector, which is goes into a standard marine radio. It's like an adapter, so if you've got an handheld what's BNC, you can use that, or you can use that. A Ritchie angler compass. Got some nice storage in here. Just needs a catch button on that because I haven't got around to doing that. All this wood, it's marine ply, and it's also been painted with epoxy, not epoxy resin, fiberglass resin, to protect it so it doesn't rot. And also, bear with me, in here is more storage. All you can see it's all been redone. All the woodwork's been redone. This strengthening part here is where one at rollers goes. That's been redone. All new timber. All been done right to the back. Obviously, you've got storage in the back of this. Sitting in the cockpit or cuddy, you want to call it. I would say from where I'm sat to the back, it's probably 10 foot from my foot, from the bottom of the seat to the cupboards at the back. Probably about 10 foot and probably 4 or 5 foot width. But you can see with that car battery there. Stainless steel grab rails. There's not much headroom in here, unfortunately. It's a lift up cuddy, should you need to. Catches here, you push these, one at each side, but it's very heavy to lift up, but you can do it if you need to for any reason. And that's your wiring, goes through there, that plugs into your marine radio. Wiring goes up there, it all goes across here, and some trunking, and that goes to all your lights and your horns and things like that. So yeah, it's not bad. Oh, and a brand new steering wheel. It's an Italian one, aluminium and wood. It's a bit stiff, but like I said, this has been probably stood for quite a while. This, that's it. It's freeing up. Probably a boring video for you, but there you go. People like to be thorough with these things when they're spending money. So yeah, there you go.